today I'm making a stop motion puppet creaky chair. Today I'm making a stop motion puppet. It's gonna be a. It's gonna be a robot, and I'm gonna use as much junk as possible to build it. I think it's gonna have a cool kind of robot exterior. It's gonna have a hard shell, like a robot kind of hard shell. Let's imagine that in a kind of white enamel. But then broken into that are gonna be some bits of junk. I'm gonna use bits of junk to kind of make it and embellish it. I've got some great pieces that I can use. I've got lots of old camera parts. That's what I'm gonna kind of use for parts of it. These ones especially, I'm thinking these are gonna fit into the eyes. Not quite like that. Yeah, they're just old metal camera parts, but they've already got a nice shine. And this one's got a little kind of spring latch mechanism on it. I think those will be great. here's our rope. Maybe he's going to have a grumpy face. I don't know. But I'm thinking also some kind of hood. He's a kind of dudey kind of warrior. And then a kind of robot hand and maybe a staff of some kind. I think that'd be really cool. For the arm, I've got these other little parts, which again are all kind of old camera pieces, but I thought those would be good, like pistons. You can imagine it. So those are gonna be the arm parts. So then we've got some kind of pistons to go in that. We'll make some fabric to go on that. So for the outside, I'm gonna 3D print the shell, and then we're gonna be able to put these metal parts into it. That is the plan for the robot. And it's, like I say, I think it's gonna be good. It's gonna be junk based. But it's going to be finished. So I'd like to make it kind of look lived in, you know, that Star Wars lived in feel. That's what I'm kind of, that's what I'm going for on this piece. So hopefully along the way, we'll have some tips and tricks on how it's all put together and give you some inspiration for your own creations. We've got the 3D printing done, and we've printed this at 70 millimeter diameter, rightly or wrongly. I think that was a good size choice for the eyes. Really, I'm using the eyes as a guide for how big the rest of it. So this looks obviously 3D printed, and the next part really is to get rid of all the marks that are going to kind of reveal it as a 3D print. We want this to look like a metal shell. So that's going to be him, and I've made this block to go behind him, and that's going to hold those cool metal eyes. Oh, and they click in quite well. And then they can sit behind that. I think that'd be quite good, actually, once they're in. So this is all going to have to be sanded and smoothed so that we've got a nice, smooth, robotic head. So this is about the third layer of sanding I've done. And I've sprayed it, sanded it back, and then sprayed again, but you can still see layer lines in it. So in order to combat that, I sprayed once more so they were in a kind of grey, and then I've used Tamiya putty to go over and spread into the small gaps of the head to make it even smoother, because all I'm trying to do is get rid of the idea that it is a 3D print. And once this has all been put in, I sprayed it, sanded it, sprayed it, and now I'm actually at my home workshop, where my garage. It's night time, and I'm spraying a layer of brown over the top of the model. This is basically going to be the base coat.
So we've made it to painting. So they've now had an undercoat of a kind of brown, and then I have sprayed them with chipping medium, which I've not tried before, this one. And now I'm going to spray over with white and, I like the sea grey. That could be good. It's about an hour interruption where I just fixed the cleaned the airbrush. Time. Oh dear. I've just done another green robot. So now we're just building up the layers of paint. I started with a green paint, but I wanted to get more a kind of pale something. So this is about the third coat now of this pale blue. And now I'm just making some backgrounds for the eyes, because otherwise they're just kind of sat in nothing. And then I thought, well, I need some like an LED light in there. So I'm making some little lenses by pressing in a doll's eye into the shape. Ooh. And using that to create the lens for the eye. And I made two of these, one for each eye. There's a different size in the eye, so they're a different thing. But they fit really well because you're able to press the doll's eye really far into the eyelet hole. This is the really fun bit. Chipping away at that layer of blue paint to reveal the brown underneath. So this is what the fluid in between, the chipping medium, has helped us achieve. And it looks really good. It's starting now to look like a robot and not like a lump of plastic, which is the whole point. It's got to look like a robot. You can see on here that there's a crack on the shell of the robot, which was a complete mistake, but I've worked with it. I think they've turned out really well, and I've not even finished painting these yet. But so far, I'm really pleased with them. So, just making some LED eyes for this robot. I've got a lot of leftover glow sticks. Not mine. Okay, and rather than actually soldering the thing together, I am just putting in some fresh cables, moving the LEDs over to here so that we can put those. Whoa, we're not blinking, no. Okay, there we go, we've got two eyes on. Those are going to be two eyes. I've got a huge roll of neutral density filter. So I'm just going to put in some little neutral density things just to reduce that, because I just want a little glow. We don't need a lot. Okay, so I've got a styrene block in the back, and I've got some wire that I've wound it. So this is going to kind of create movement for the head, to hopefully allow us to do a bit of animation. Now, I've also got these metal piston-y things, if you remember that. So we're going to kind of put those in to the neck to try and hopefully they'll glue to the wire inside. Okay, we've got those glued in. So I've moved to the animation space, and I've got a very beat up old computer, which is for my, which is running Dragonframe, an equally old Canon 5D Mark II, still really good for animation. And we've got our character set up. He's got LED lights glowing in his eyes. We've got one light running as our main light, and then we've got a kind of fill light in a yellow. I hope that'll be all right. LEDs are really still too bright. Like, you could do a separate pass if you could do that. to finish this video, we're just going to animate a small head turn. And that'll be our robot, our grungy robot puppet complete. If you enjoyed this video and you want to see more, click on this link. Please like and subscribe. Thanks, bye.